Good morning. Good morning. Welcome home to the Lord's house on this, the Lord's Day, the frozen and chosen among us here in our Fredsville family. I'm glad you all thought out enough. Welcome. Coming up this week, we've got lots of fun things today. Hopefully our contractors will be able to get through the snow and get here. We'll have our solar energy presentation to talk about what does the potential of solar look like at Fredsville. There's some information in your bulletin if you'd like to look that over. And I'd be glad to answer any questions you have. And our property team would too. Also this week, Tuesday, we have Bible study every Tuesday at 9 a.m. At Carol Anderson's house. Now, weather depending, we'll see how that goes this week. But that is open to all, so come and study God's word with us, have some time of prayer and sharing and some laughs along the way. And Cabin Fever is on Wednesday at 12 noon. That is what we make it. It is a potluck. It is a game potluck. So bring what food you like, bring what games you like, and let's have some fun and conversation together. Bring some warmth into this cold weather. Are there other announcements or things you'd like to bring up? Don't all talk at once. Let's prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, creator of darkness and light, word of truth, wind sweeping over the waters. Amen. Please rise as we sing, "You have come down to the lake." Thank you. us confess our sin in the presence of God and in the presence of one another. God, our rock and refuge, we pour out our hearts before you. We have known you, but we have always loved you. We have wounded one another and sinned against you. We have not always recognized the Holy Spirit dwelling in each of us. Remember your covenant, renew your creation, restore us, that we might proclaim your good news to all. Amen. Hear this word of forgiveness. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. God has spoken. The time of grace is now. In Jesus, the reign of God has come near, and by the authority of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are God's beloved. Amen. Our Kyrie and hymn of praise you can find on page 213 of your hymnal if you want to follow along with the music. Please sing with us. Just give you a little warm feeling. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us join our hearts and our voices in prayer. Almighty God, by grace alone you call us and accept us in your service. Strengthen us by your Spirit and make us worthy of your call. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated that we may hear from God's holy word this day.
Good morning. The first reading today is taken from the book of Jonah, chapter 3, verses 1 to 5 and 10. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, "Get up, go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you." So Jonah set out and went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly large city, a 3 days' walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk, and he cried out, 40 days more and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and everyone, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil ways, God changed God's mind about the calamity that God had said God would bring upon them, and God did not do it. Word of God, word of life. Now we will read Psalm 62 responsively. For God alone I wait in silence. Truly my hope is in God. God alone is my rock and salvation, my stronghold, so that I shall never be shaken. In God is my deliverance and my honor. God is my strong rock and my refuge. Put your trust in God always, O people. Pour out your hearts before the one who is our refuge. Those of high degree are but a fleeting breath. Those of low estate cannot be trusted. Placed on the scales together, put no trust in extortion. In robbery, take no empty pride. The wealth increase, set not your heart upon it. God has spoken once, twice have I heard it. Power belongs to God. Steadfast love belongs to you, O Lord, for you repay all according to their deeds. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, and will be forever. Amen. The second reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 7. Brothers and sisters, the appointed time has grown short. From now on, let even those who have wives be as though they had none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they were not rejoicing, and those who buy as though they had no possessions, and those who deal with the world as though they had no dealings with it. For the present form of this world is passing away. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to rise for the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Now, after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As Jesus went a little farther, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending their nets. Immediately he called them and said, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. All right, any younger friends out there? Come and join me up here. There's one friend. Do we have other friends? We do have other friends. Look at you all. It's okay. You can hear me from back there, too. It's okay. Yep, you just watch from the safety of your pew. We're good? Not even a thumbs up today. All right, that's okay. Hi. So, come on up here and join us. So today we talked about Jesus calling his first disciples. Did you hear what they used to do? What did they do? Do you know what Peter and his brother and everybody else used to do? Did they go fishing? They made their job fishing. And Jesus said, "Come with me and I'll help you fish for people." He wanted them to come and do the work of the gospel, right? Now, could they continue to serve their neighbors? God calls us to love our neighbors, right? Can we love our neighbors? Do you have to dress like me and do what I do to love our neighbors? You have to preach and that? No, you don't have to do this. You can love your neighbors other ways, right? Do you think there's other people out here that do things to love their neighbors in ways different from one another? What kind of jobs do you think they do to love their neighbors? Do you know what some of these folks do? Because these folks out here are really good examples of how to follow Jesus. They love their neighbors by doing all kinds of things. Some people love their neighbors by doing what I do, and we preach and we pray and bless people. Some people use tools, like screwdrivers, and they fix things to love their neighbors because that's the skills God gave them. I know that there's some really talented people out here that are teachers. They teach. They see you at school, and they help teach you things. There's people who teach music and people who help people learn how to learn better. They don't teach, but they do other things to help people, right? Your mom's good with numbers, isn't she? Yeah, she's really good with numbers, and that's how she serves God. There's people out here that are really good to work with creation, and they farm, and they plant, and they know how to do that really well. And so, we can all serve God doing different kinds of jobs. And Jesus calls us where we are in our jobs, in our everyday lives, people just like you, and gives you skills and ways that you can love God and love your neighbors. So I think that we should pray about all the different ways that God shares good news and love in this world. What do you think? Think that's a good idea? Okay, let's pray. Ready? Holy God, we give you thanks. We give you thanks for all the gifts that you give us and all the ways that you help us love one another. We pray that you would always invite us. Invite us into good ways to live with one another, to serve one another, and especially to love Jesus, now and always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Good job, gang. See you next time. So how many ways do you love your neighbor? What skills and abilities did God give you? And how do we respond to God's invitation in the world using what God has given us? I think that is a big question that we're addressing in today's text. When God speaks, you see, things happen. From the very dawn of creation, the voice of God hovered over the waters and made stuff happen. The word of the Lord, or in Hebrew, Dvar Adonai, the creative engineer that made reality into being and sets life into motion for all of creation and for you and for me. The word of the Lord is the kinetic energy of today's text. It moves each one of these characters and moves their lives into new directions that sometimes they didn't even expect. The word of the Lord sends Jonah, despite all of his resistance, to proclaim the message of God to Nineveh, which is actually the land of his enemies, the last people he wanted to go visit. And then that same word of the Lord overthrows the people of Nineveh and turns their whole community around so that they act in ways of repentance. They act differently towards God and towards their neighbor. Paul, well, he's a good one, somebody who's really experienced radical change from God. He's arguing that all the nearness of God will transform our whole lives, transform our relationships, our emotions, our feelings, our economic practices, all of it. And finally, we travel with Jesus by the Sea of Galilee as he invites these fishermen to walk away from life on the water and to walk and live in new ways of the kingdom on dry land. God's invitation to live the gospel changes lives. It can change yours too. Sometimes we look at these stories and we hear them and it makes it seem like it's so simple to just drop everything. Follow Jesus, right? Follow me. Okay. Good for them. Because we know it's not that easy. At least in Luke's account, the disciples seem a little more hesitant. They don't make it seem quite so easy. The reality is that a lot of us, we're a lot more like Jonah than we'd like to admit, aren't we? You know. John, we resist God's invitation to change our lives. But, you really want me to what? That can't be right. I must have heard that wrong, God. Could you just say that again? Because maybe I'll hear it differently this time. You ever do that? I know I have. The challenge comes when we ask God to say it again, when we continue to just push back a little bit and say, you couldn't have meant that, could you? Get ready, because God will come again and invite again. Remember, Jonah is on round two. Do you hear that at the beginning of the text? The word of the Lord came to Jonah again. That first time around, Jonah ran away. He ran in the opposite direction toward Tarshish. He got in a boat and ran away from God's call to Nineveh. And we see where that ended up, right? He got thrown in the water, swallowed by a fish, spewed out on dry land covered in fish spit and sand. And then God said, let's try that again. Go to Nineveh and proclaim what I say. Ugh. Okay. It's funny, isn't it? It's funny to think about that until we have to remember, how will you respond to God's call? Is it going to take fish spit and sand for you or not? The story of these first disciples, though, this is one that resonates with me. It hits a little close to home. Two brothers working by the water hear Jesus' invitation to go. And they do. They go and they follow Jesus into a new way of life. Good for them. But they left their father and the hired hands in the boat. A full generation of this family has just walked out the door and left the family business. That's a story we can relate to. It's a reality we face in an ever more mobile society. People move. God invites people, gives people ever new directions in life to different vocations and locations, wherever life may take them. And that kind of change can be hard for all of us. I know that reality all too well. You see, I am a third generation electrician. I didn't always do this. Paul Gable at Sons Electric. It bears my family name. My grandfather and my grandmother started that company. My dad and my brother, they still work there. And I worked there alongside them, with my dad and my brother, for years, with the hired employees. Wiring airports and generators, factories and solar panels, and so much more. That is the work that I did. I was loving my neighbor by doing good work, the work I was called to do. Getting power back on for families that were cold. That was my job. And then something new happened. No one, including me, expected me to be anywhere else. Then God invited me to something new and said, follow me. And that changed everything. I'll be honest, when God first called, I did my best Jonah impression. You would have been impressed. There was no whale spit, though. For 2 years, I ran. I ran from that invitation to follow in new ways. I ran asking for clarification, asking again and again, God, are you sure you mean that? Do you really want me to what? Hoping that God would lower the bar, make it a little easier so I could just stay in my happy little comfort zone and not have to do so much different. And then the Holy Spirit continued introducing change into my well-laid plans. That invitation became abundantly clear when holding tools like these, I started singing that glory to God all on my own while I was wiring electrical panels, and things are gonna change, aren't they? And then it was time. It was time for me to put down what I was putting in the way. Put down the tools of one trade so that my hands would be free to pick up the tools of another. You're still serving and loving my neighbors, right? But God had new tools for me to use, new ways for me to proclaim good news into people's lives. And I can imagine Jesus might have said, follow me, and I'll help you share and shed light into the lives of others. Because we don't put down who we are when we follow Jesus. Jesus transforms who we are and helps us speak in new ways into the world. That's just my story, though. What's your story? How are you called in your daily life to love God and love your neighbors with the skills and gifts God has given you? What are the gifts and the passions that you bless the lives of others with each day, and you might not even know it? How is Jesus inviting you to transform those skills, that language of love, and tell the good news of the kingdom come near so the world may hear? The gospel is spoken and lived out in the language of our daily lives. It doesn't just have to be from pulpits. It's served from teachers' desks, from piano benches, from work desks, from tools to all kinds of things. God's message of love is spoken into and for this world and for the people that desperately need to hear it in new ways that make sense. Because I think that's what Jesus meant when he said, follow me and I will make you fish for people. He was talking to fishermen in metaphor, giving them new language for their lives. The act of fishing is going out and pulling something into a new reality, pulling a fish from one reality into another. That's what God does with these fishermen. He invited them to invite and pull people into a new reality, life oriented by the kingdom on earth. And you might argue that that metaphor dies and say, well, the fish dies in that process. Yeah, and so do we, according to Romans chapter 6. In baptism, we die with Christ and are raised with Christ to new life. New life of the kingdom on earth as it is in heaven, that kingdom for which we pray. We are called from the waters of baptism. We are called forth like those first disciples, follow me, to live in the new reality as the kingdom of God, people in the world. These are the waters where God calls you by name and says, follow me, child of God. God's invitation to live the gospel changes lives, one day at a time. We're called to a life oriented for the mission of God in the world, from your tractor seat to your desk to your life at home. Like Jonah, we may be called by God and invited to places we don't want to go. That's okay. Like the people of Nineveh, we may be called to change as a community, not just as individuals. And that's good too. And like the disciples, don't be surprised when God finds you in the ordinary time of your everyday life and activity and invites you to something new. Jesus' invitation continues to echo among us. Follow me. And the Spirit stirs with the kinetic energy of the kingdom on earth, creating the induction currents of grace, hope, peace, and love in the lives of people like you and me. God's invitation to live the gospel changes lives. It changes lives in the way we respond. And the way we respond will change the lives of people around us and the world around us too. Thanks be to God. Gathered at the shores of baptism, what is it we believe?
We believe in one God, Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made. Of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please be seated that we may pray. As we celebrate Christ embodied in human form, we pray for God's blessing on the Church, the world, all of creation, and each person in need. God, our invitation. Make us attentive to your voice, calling us to step outside our comfort zones to follow Jesus. May we trust that you have given us all we need for the work we are called to do in our community and in this world. Light of God, shine upon us and within us. God of renewal, you call forth life from the waters. Guide our care of creation and sources of water that sustain life. Hold us accountable for our stewardship of natural resources and all people who depend on them. In this cold season, give rest and renewal to the land. Light of God, shine upon us and within us. God of hope and refuge, in Jesus you walk in ways of justice and offer mercy. Change the hearts of those driven by greed and violence. Inspire leaders to follow your way of justice and peace. Especially we pray for peace in Ukraine and peace in the Holy Land. Light of God, shine upon us and within us. God of compassion, you care for the suffering, care for the survivors of assaults and sexual abuse, and sustain the work of all who help them to recover quality of life. Keep safe any who live under the threat of violence, those living in poverty and any among us who are ill or in pain. Especially we remember Leona, Carol, Marcia, Jane, Carol, Janine, and all those we name in our hearts and on our lips. Light of God, shine upon us and within us. God of resurrection and new life, as the first disciples shared the good news, empower us and this faith community to be open to your call. When we are uncertain, give us faith to step out into the unknown. When we have strayed from your ways, redirect us. Help us to accompany one another in our beloved community together. Light of God, shine upon us and within us. God who holds the saints, we trust your resurrection welcome. Comfort those who grieve this day, especially the family of Robert Minicus. Help us to continue living, placing our hope in the salvation of your kingdom. Light of God, shine upon us and within us. Knowing the Holy Spirit intercedes for us, we offer these prayers and the silent prayers of our hearts. In the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share a sign of God's peace with one another. Please be seated as our worship continues with the gathering of our offerings for God's mission among us. Let us offer prayer over our offering this day. God, our light, your mercy shines with abundance upon the earth. Receive and bless these gifts that we bring before you. Teach us patience and hope as we care for those in need. Let our stewardship be a sign of your steadfast love and faithfulness for all people, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. We turn now to God's holy meal. The Lord be with you. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By the leading of a star, he was shown forth to all nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaimed him your beloved Son. In the miracle of water turned to wine, he revealed your glory. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth, and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Comforts the weak and the strong, a light, the God who shatters the darkness with a light of hope and love. We gather around this meal of grace, remembering that in the night in which Jesus washed the disciples' feet, he took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, Jesus' death and resurrection, we await the day when Jesus shall return to free all the earth from the bonds of slavery and death. Come, Lord Jesus, and let the church say amen.
Amen.
Send your Holy Spirit, our advocate, to fill the hearts of all who share this bread and cup with the courage and wisdom to pursue love and justice in all the world. Come, Spirit of freedom, and let the church say amen.
Amen.
Join our prayers with the prayers and praise of your prophets and martyrs of this and every age, rejoicing in the hope of resurrection life, we might live in the freedom and hope and light of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And let the church say, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
These are the gifts of God, given for the people of God. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace this day and always. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, you look upon us in love and refresh our souls through the gift of bread and wine. Send us out reflecting the light of your grace to tell the story of Jesus Christ, our bright morning star. Amen. Beloved children of God, what came into being in Christ was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The light of Christ shine on you with grace and mercy and fill you with joy and peace. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We go out singing a favorite, This Little Light of Mine. I expect to see those little lights out there. Right, good. All right, please rise as we sing with joy. Go in peace, guided by the light of Christ.